ओम अज्ञान तिमिरंधस्य ज्ञानांजन शलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। वंदेहं श्रीगुरुः श्रीयुतपदकमलं श्रीगुरून् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं सहगण रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजन सहितं श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य देवं श्रीराधा कृष्णापादान् सहगण ललिता श्री विशाखान्वितांश्च। हे कृष्णा करुणा सिंधो दीनबंधो जगतपते गोपेश गोपिका कांत राधा कांत नमोस्तुते। तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रिये। नमो महावदान्याय कृष्णा प्रेम प्रदायिने कृष्णाय कृष्णा चैतन्य नामने गौरत्विषे नमः। पंचतत्वात्मकं कृष्णं भक्तरूपस्वरूपकं भक्तावतारं भक्ताख्यं नमामि भक्तशक्तिकं। श्री कृष्णा चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंदा श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासदि गौर भक्तवृंदा। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। जन्माद्यस्य यतोऽन्वयादितरतश्चार्थे शुभिज्ञस्वराट् तेने ब्रह्म हृदाय आदिकवये मुह्यन्ति यत्सूरयः। तेजो वदाम यथा विनिमयो यत्र त्रिसर्गो मृषा धाम्ना स्वेन सदा निरस्तकुहकं सत्यं परं धीमहि। नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरयेत्। स्वस्ति अस्तु विश्वस्य खलः प्रसीदतां ध्यायन्तु भूतानि शिवं मिथो धिया। मनश्च भद्रं भजता दधोक्षजे आवेश्यतां नो मतिरप्यहैतुकी। So we are reading from Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 10, Chapter number 3, Verse number 22. So this is right after Krishna, he took birth in the prison of Kamsa, and these are prayers of, we are reading prayers of Vasudev. So he appeared there, they saw him, and then Vasudev, he started praying to him. So this is part of that. So in the previous verse we read that he told him that he has appeared to destroy the unrighteous kings, Rajanya, Sangyasur Koti, Yuthapai, Nirvyuha Mana Nirhanishya Chechamo, that you will kill these kings along with their armies. So that's what we studied. And now he continues. I am Twasadhyastava Janmanau Grihe श्रुत्वाग्रजांस्ते नवधीत सुरेश्वरः सते अवतारं पुरुषहि समर्पितं सुत्वैधनैवापि सुरत्यदायुधा. सो ही इज वरीड अबाउट कंसा कमिंग एंड ट्राइंग टू किल कृष्ण बिकॉज earlier the elder brothers have been killed by him. So therefore says, I am tu asabhya. So I am means this, and he is speaking as if his Kamsa is just on the other side of the wall. So he says that he is very asabhya. So sabhya means those who are noble people. Asabhya means rowdies, uncultured. So he says he is asabhya. Sabhya also means those who know what is rasa, who know what is kavya rasa, suhirda. So sahirdya, sabhya. So he is asabhya, he does not know, because Krishna is so beautiful, but he does not have appreciation for that. So therefore Vasudev says that he is asabhya. And tav janma nav grihe shrutva agrajanste nevadhit sureshwara. What is the proof that he is asabhya? So he says that even when he heard that the eighth child of Devaki is going to kill him, he killed the earlier six, because seventh was removed by Yogamaya Balram. So he says, Srutva agrajanste nevadhita Sureshwara. That, O Sureshwara, he, when he heard this, that your birth has happened in our house, tab janma navgrihe, then he will come here to kill you, because he has already killed. Agrajanste nevadhita सते अवतारं पुरुषैः समर्पितं श्रुत्वा अधुनैव अभिसरति अच्युताय अति उदायुधा सरति उदायुधा. सो व्हेन ही विल हियर फ्रॉम द गार्ड्स पुरुष द पीपल अराउंड द प्रिजन हु हैव बीन केप्ट देयर, सो व्हेन ही विल हियर फ्रॉम देम दैट यू हैव अपीयर्ड हियर, then he will immediately come now itself, adhuna eva, not tomorrow. He is not going to wait till morning. Say adhuna eva abhisarati, and he is using the word abhisarati means he is already walking towards this place, means no time delay. Therefore, and how is he coming? He is not coming with some gift. Usually when a child is born to a sister, then in India it's a custom that they have to carry some gifts for the new baby, the cloths for the child and some special food, modaka, which are prepared from methi, lotus seed, ghee. These articles which are actually good for the mother, because they actually produce milk and also give immunity to the mother so that the child does not get infection. So these are carried, but he is coming udayudha. So he is coming with a weapon in the hand, and that weapon is also not like you have a sword, kshatriyas carry sword that is in the scabbard hanging on the side. No, he is coming it in the hand. Udayudha means upraised arm. So it's very dangerous person. So let's read the commentary of Sri Vishnath. So atastvat kripaya tav sarvam सर्वैश्वर्यम अहम् जानामि एव तदपि अविवेक समुद्रो मया दुस्तर एव यतः सांप्रतिकस्य महादुष्टकंसस्य दौरात्म्यं त्वां ज्ञापयामि इति आह अयम्। सो ही सेज दैट बाय योर ग्रेस आई कैन अंडरस्टैंड योर ऐश्वर्या, तब ऐश्वर्या, बिकॉज अर्लियर ही सेड दैट यू आर गोइंग टू डिस्ट्रॉय द इरिलीजियस corrupt kings and their armies, so why he is afraid of now Kamsa coming to kill him? This is contradictory. On one side he is praising him that he has come to remove the unrighteous kings from the planet. On the other side he is afraid that Kamsa is going to kill him. So therefore he has both the moods. His mood is the mixture of Aishwarya and also mixture of Madhurya, thinking Krishna as a human being. So we studied that Aishwarya and Madhurya, right? In Vishnu Chakravarti's book, Raghuvartma Chandrika, he explained nicely what is the difference. So this is the difference, that Aishwarya is that when you understand that Krishna is Ishvara, and Madhurya is when you consider him as a Nara, human being. So he says that by your grace I know your Aishwarya, because Krishna's Aishwarya is also understood only by his grace. His Madhurya of course is understood only by his grace, otherwise people do not understand and mistake him to be an ordinary people. So mudha mam avijananti manushintanam ashritam, they disrespect me thinking me to be just an ordinary human being. So it is good to have this both from practical reasons. If you don't know the his Aishwarya, then you will disrespect. If you know only Aishwarya, then you will not love him. So he has both here. So he says, Sarvam Aishwarya Maham Janami Eva. So Sarvam Aishwarya means I know your Aishwarya fully. I do not have any Brahma. Right? I have Brahma. No Brahma. So Tadvati Tat Prakarkam Jnanam Prama. Anybody remembers Tark Sangraha? Yes, you should revise now. Your knowledge is getting rusted. So Brahma is Atadvati Tat Prakarkam Jnanam, is Brahma or Aprama. And Tadvati Tat Prakarkam Jnanam is Prama. To know an object having the characteristic of that object, that is means to know something as that object which has the qualities of that object, that is Brahma. If something has the qualities of gold and you know it to be gold, that is Brahma. If it does not have the qualities of gold and you know it to be gold, that is Brahma. So he says that I have Brahma. You have Aishwarya and I know this. So janami eva tadapi avivek samudro maya dustarai. Yet I have fallen into this sea of aviveka. So it is very difficult to deal with Krishna because he is not clear cut person. When you have Vishnu, he is clear cut Bhagavan, forehand, and he has his insignia, so no mistake is done. But Krishna is difficult to grasp, comprehend. So he says, it is very difficult for me to cross over this sea of aviveka or this confusion. That are you God, are you human being? On one side you are showing, because he appeared with four hands, but he is little, small. He is not grown up Vishnu. So he has all the symptoms of Vishnu, but he is like mini version of Vishnu. Looks like a small baby standing there. So this is confusing. Shall we take him to be God? Shall we take him to be our child? So that is the Aviveka. Right? So Viveka means Vichir Viveka, to make a distinction. What is what? So here he is at Aviveka. Yatah sampratikasya mahadushta kamsasya dauratmyam tvam gyapyam. And therefore I am going to tell you the situation at present. What is in the present context? That Kamsa, he is Mahadushta. Not only Dushta, but Mahadushta. So Duspradushana Dhatu means polluted mind. And Mahadushta means highly polluted. There is a big virus in him. Not only that, there is a virus, he is virus personified. Right? He has so much virus that he cannot understand the rasa. That's why he is asabhya. Right? If you have virus, there is no rasa. That's what they say. You get virus, you lose the taste. Don't smell or taste food properly. This is because of the virus, no rasa. Without rasa is virus. So, therefore I am informing you about him, about his dushtata, about his wicked nature, how he is wicked, how he is so asuric. So then he speaks this ayam tu. This is how he begins. Ayam tu asabhya. ननु ममैतत् अलौकिक रूप माधुर्य आस्वादिन निमग्नो माम न प्रहरिष्यति प्रत्युत प्रीणयिष्यति इति तत्रह असभ्य. सो नाउ इफ कृष्ण सेज दैट व्हाई आर यू सेइंग दैट ही इज गोइंग टू बी दुष्ट, लुक एट मी, आई एम सो ब्यूटीफुल, राइट, परम माधुर्य, आई एम सो स्वीट. Small little boy, small children look very sweet, and on top of that he has alaukik rupa madhuri. He is not laukika, he is adbhuta. This was described here, right? Tam adbhuta balakam. That's how it came, the sloka. Tam adbhuta balakam ambujekshanam chaturbhujam sankha gadaridahidham. Number 9. So he is adbhuta balaka. He is not an ordinary child. So ordinary child also looks attractive, isn't it? Babies look attractive. But he is extraordinary baby, paramadbhut. So he is very beautiful, very attractive. So Krishna is himself saying this, that I am alaukik. I am not a laukika person. So Rupa Madhurya Ashwadhu Nimagno Mamna Parishati. He says, as soon as he sees my beauty, my form, my sweetness, my smile, then he will become absorbed in that. And then he will not think of attacking me. This is his view. He's thinking like that. So Vasudev says that no. That will not happen. Why? Because he is asabhya. You know, everybody has some taste. Different people like different type of taste. So here in India people like, you know, food with lot of chili. Western people don't like it. So sabhya people have one type of taste, asabhya people have another type of taste. Everybody does not like the same type of food, right? If you take the cows, cows in India, cows in America eat same food. There is no problem. You don't have to think. If you have taken care of cows in India, you can take care of cows in America also. They like same. But if you have to take care of people in India and then cook for Americans or Western people, you have to be expert in knowing their taste. So he says that this person, he is asabhya, so his taste is different. Rasasvade tu hi sabhyatvam eva iti bhava. He says to have this rasa which you are talking about, the rasa of beauty, of sweetness, of love, so that only sabhya people can understand. So sabhya means those who can sit in the assembly of scholars, learned people. To understand what is rasa, you have to have a lot of education. Rasa is not as people think. Everybody talks about rasa, rasika bhakta. No, it is the highest thing. For that you have to know Vyakaran, you have to know Nyaya, you have to know Vedanga, Upanishads, Sankhya, and then you have to know Sahitya. After all that, then you can understand what is rasa. Rasa is not which people say just because something sounds good, it looks nice, then it is known. This rasa is a very technical word. So it is when vibhav, anubhav, sanchari bhav, they mix together, then there is rasa nispatti. So that is the rasa, that's a different, the same word of course can be used in so many different ways. Everybody has some rasa and everybody is looking for rasa in this material world, right? Everybody is looking for some rasa. Not only in food but in other things also. You go for watching some match, movie, picnic, then if it is not good, you say, kuch ras nahi aaya. There was no fun. So you did not like it. It was not to your taste. So different people have different tastes. Some people like poetry, some people like painting, some people like music, some people like sports. Some people just like to be sleeping. They have their rasa. So here we and they are talking about rasa. He is talking about the specific sahitya rasa. Pibhata bhagavata rasam. So that is the rasa which he is talking. So that, for that he says only sabhya people can understand that, not ordinary people. Ordinary people do not have the requisite qualification for that. That's why it is said that to have understanding of rasa, one has to be sruhit, right? So sabhya, rasika. So that has to be understood what it means. It is not for everyone. So therefore he says that he will not be influenced by your beauty or sweetness because he is asabhya. He does not have the taste for this. He does not have the samskara of this. Right? Ubhay samskar ujjwala. In Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, Rupa Goswami says to taste, not only that you have to have knowledge, then you have to have samskara of this life and previous life. If you don't have the samskara from previous life, still you cannot taste the rasa. So both lives are needed. So ubhay samskar. So he does not have this. So that's why he says rasa ashvada hetur hi sabhyatvam eva iti bhava. That the hetu, the cause, which means the qualification for tasting this rasa is to be a sabhya, and he is not that. So therefore it is not possible that he will have the taste or he will be influenced by your duty. Himsayam kaimutyamaha tava ityadi. So then he shows it, he proves that. What is the proof? So he gives the Kaimuttya Nyaya. So you know Kaimuttya. Kaimuttya means it is called a fortiori principle in English. Means something if you can lift 100 kg of weight or 200 pounds of weight, then what is the problem in lifting 5 pounds or 5 kg? That is called Kaimuttya Nyaya. So he is going to prove to him by Kaimuttya that what is the problem. He says Tava Ityadi. So in the verse he says that so Tav agrajans nevadhit, Tav agrajan janma nav grehe nevadhit. That when he heard that your elder brothers, when they were born in our house, means in the prison here, when he heard about that, then he killed them. And this is knowing that it is only the eighth child who will kill. So you are the eighth one. Although previously Narada Rishi has convinced him that anyone can be eighth, but now seven has passed. So now there is no confusion. In the previous seven, you are not sure whether this is actually eighth or seventh or fifth or sixth or which one is this. But now it is for sure that those sixth have been killed, so obviously they are not going to kill him. They are not the cause of his death. Seventh, there was an abortion. And this is the eighth. So certainly he will not leave you. So that is the Kaimuttya here. Tava Ityadi. So how would he know it is midnight? He was born at midnight. Does he have some CCTV fitted here? He is watching. Even if there is a CCTV fitted here, he must be sleeping now, midnight. So how would he know that he is going to come just right away here? So he says, Satyavataram purushai samarpitam sutva adhunaiva abhisarti udayudha. That his servants are here. He has made arrangements that he will get the news and they will come running, he will come running. So samarpitam kathitam. Samarpitam here means, samarpitam generally means to offer something, but here means to convey to him the news of your birth. Niveditam kathitam abhimukhameva sarati iti. So he is saying abhisarati. So abhimukhameva sarati means he is already walking towards, as if he is already walking towards this place. So this abhisarati, the present tense, is used here in the sense of future, right? So the immediate past and immediate future, for that also you can use the present tense. So why present is used here? To say that there is not going to be any delay. If he uses the future, then future is anything. From now onwards, it could be tomorrow, day after tomorrow, after 6 months, everything is future. But to say abhisarati means without any delay. That is the significance of this. As soon as he hears that a child is born to Devaki from his servants, then he is immediately going to jump out from his bed and come running here. He is not going to dress up or anything. So that is abhisarati. So tam agata prayam aham pashyami iti ato adhunaeva rupamidam upsambhara. So he says, I am seeing as if he is already here. Adhunaeva, now itself. Therefore, please, you unmanifest this form. Because if he sees this, then there is certainly no doubt. Tasmin agate tu upsang jiharshatah purvam kim bhavishyati iti me mahakampa iti bhava. So he says that if you are going to change your form after he comes, then I don't know what will be the situation. So better you do it before he appears on the scene, because then he will be too much irritated by seeing. So this was the last verse of Vasudeva spoken by him. Now Sri Shuka Vaja. Any question on this?
What's the verse number?
Verse number 22, chapter 3, 10th canto. So we are on verse 23 now. Sri Shuka Uvacha. Athayanam Atmajam Viksha Mahapurusha Lakshanam Devaki Tam Upadhavat Kamshad Bhita Suvishmita. So now Sri Sukadeva Goswami speaks to Parikshit Maharaj that after that, what happened when Vasudev spoke the previous verse? So he says that after that, Mother Devaki, when she saw her son who had all the symptoms of Mahapurusha, means of Supreme Person, so then she prayed to him, Tama Upadhavata Kamsad Bhita Sumismita. And at the same time she was fearful of Kamsa. So she had two types of emotions, two types of bhavas. One was bhaya, fear. Another was vismaya. So therefore it is called bhita and vismita. She had fear because Kamsa will come. After all, they have had the experience already of their 6 children being killed by him. And also she had the vismaya of seeing this small boy with 4 hands and having all the characteristics of Vishnu in him. So these are the two emotions which are manifest in her mind. So, yes.
Which emotion is Vishmaya, please?
Vishmaya means wonder. So atha patyur bhayam drishtva upasamipam bhita iti sarupam anu samharantam smayamanam tam alakshya parmeshwaratva hankarena kams bhayam na ganayati tadaham hanta king karomi iti vivala iti artha. So now he explains, Vishnath Chakravarti Thakur, that she saw the fear of her husband Sri Vasudev, that how Vasudev was fearful of Kamsa. And upasamipam bhita, so looks like there was a difference. I don't know if this upa is referring to upadhavat here, which is a separate word, but he is bringing the word upa. So upasamipam bhita iti. So she is close by and she is fearful. Sarupam anupsangharantam smayamanam tamalakshya. So he is conjecturing, Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, that Krishna did not unmanifest his 4-handed form. He kept standing there. Rather, he was smiling. So she thought, what is this? I am scared, my husband is scared, and this baby is only smiling. सो ही थॉट ओ परमेश्वरत्व अहंकारेण कम्स भयम न गणयति दैट ही हैज हैविंग द अहंकार दैट आई एम परमेश्वर एंड देयरफॉर ही इज डिसरिगार्डिंग द फियर ऑफ कम्स बिकॉज व्हाट इज कम्स आई क्रिएट यूनिवर्सेस लेफ्ट एंड राइट सो व्हाट कम्स कैन डू टू मी सो देयरफॉर शी इज सेइंग दैट He is not afraid of Kamsa because he is thinking, I am Parameshwara. But tadaham hanta king karomi. So now, alas, alas, what can I do? He is not listening to us and is standing there fearlessly. So therefore she is vivala. She is agitated in her mind. So this is the emotion, that is the meaning of fear. That she has vishmaya, she has wonder, at the same time she has fear of Kamsa. So suvismita ityasya parmeshwarasya agre kamsa khalu ko varakaha. Tadapi avyor bhayam vardhate veti koyam aviveko dustaraiti bhava. So why there is a vishmaya? Why there is such a wonder, this feeling of wonder is there. So the feeling of wonder is not because Krishna is there standing with four hands. He had another explanation. So his explanation is that Parmeshwarasya agre kamsa khalu ko varake. Says, what is the significance of kamsa in comparison to Parameshwara? It's just an insignificant being. Where is Krishna, Parameshwara, Ishwara, Krishna, Parma? So, and where is Kamsa? What is, there is no comparison. Yet, still I have this fear in me. So this is the cause of vismaya. Because vismaya or wonder comes when something is unprecedented, when you experience something which is unprecedented, something which you have never experienced before. So generally when you have an understanding of something, then you are not worried about that. You know, okay, this is the situation, it is happening like this. When you do not have clear understanding, then you may have doubt, confusion, fear, all this. But when something is clear, then it is clear. Especially in this particular case, when you know that Krishna is Bhagavan, He is Parameshwara, then where is the question of fear? So, but still he says, tadapi avyor bhayam vardhate eva, that not only that we have fear of Kamsa, but this fear is increasing. As time is passing, the fear is also increasing. Because they know that any time now Kamsa is going to come. So he says that Kopi ayam viveko dustara. He says this aviveka is dustara. It is difficult to get rid of it. You cannot get rid of this fear even after having the proper understanding that Krishna is Parameshwara. So this is because she is mother, she has motherly affection for Krishna. It's not that she only understands him to be Parameshwara like a Shant Bhakta. If she was a Shant Bhakta, then she would not have any fear. But because she also has Vatsalya Bhav, the motherly affection, so that motherly affection is not leaving her. Even after understanding that he is Parameshwar. And because of that, she is naturally fearing for her son. So that shows her Vatsalya Bhav towards Krishna. That it is intense, although not as intense as in case of Yashoda, who did not get the feeling that Krishna is Parameshwar, otherwise she would not try to bind him or chastise him. So Devaki has understanding of Krishna as Parameshwara, but that does not mean that she does not have the affection as a mother to him. So that also is there, and she is unable to get over it. Therefore, she is having these mixed emotions. So, mixture of two bhavas is being described here. So then she prays to him. Sri Devaki Uvacha. Sri Devaki said, Rupam yat tat prahur avyaktam adyam brahma jyotir nirgunam nirvikaram satta matram nirvishesham niriham svatam sakshad vishnur adhyatma deepaha. So this is a highly philosophical verse. Sridhar Swami's commentary I don't bring, maybe tomorrow we can read. He writes a very nice commentary on this from philosophy. Every word he explains related to one specific school of philosophy. And then the next word in the sloka refutes that and ultimately establishes him as Vishnu. So all these words, avyaktam, adhyam, brahm, jyotir, nirgunam, nirvikaram, satta matram, nirvishesham, niriham, they all belong to different schools of thought, different darshanas. And then the final one is Vishnu, that is Vishnu adhyatmadi. So rupam yat tat prahur avyaktam adhyam. He says that form, that some particular form which they say, prahu means they say, means the philosophers say, avyaktam, the unmanifest. So that what they say as adhyam, the original, or Brahma, or Jyoti, the effulgence, Nirgunam, which is beyond the gunas, Nirvikaram, which is beyond all modifications, Satta Matram, which is pure existence, Nirvishesham, without any varieties in it, Niriham, without any action in it, Satvam Sakshad Vishnu Radhyatmani. So that reality which is described with all these characteristics, that is you who are directly Vishnu, the transcendental consciousness. So that is Adhyatma Deepa. So Adhyatma Deepa means who illuminates everybody's intelligence, or who is the source of consciousness. So that is you directly. So Sakshat means that not by any imposition, not by some adhyasa. So that is Krishna. So Sri Vishnath says, Kincha Bhakta Khalu Stutya Bhagavantamapi Vashikurvanti Iti Prasiddher Enam Mahahatinam Stutyaeva Vashikritya Savachanam Sthapyami Iti Mansi Vimrishya Bho Parmeshwara Avyoho Pratikshanameva Ati Bhaye Vardhamane Api Tav Bhashankaeva Nastitya. So he is relating this with his explanation in the previous commentary that she was Vismita, she was surprised that why I am having so much fear, and the fear was because Krishna was not listening or changing his form. So now she is thinking as follows. She says, Bhakta khalu stutya bhagavantam api vasya kurvanti. The devotees, they control Bhagwan by reciting prayers. They recite prayers to Bhagwan, then Bhagwan comes under their control. So he says, this is well known. Iti prasiddhair. So he says, this Krishna is very obstinate, mahahathinam. And because he is very obstinate, so I will also bring him under my control by my prayers. See the solution. Right? If you praise somebody, that person becomes little soft and can listen to you. So Mahatinam Stutyaya Vashikritya. And then when he has come under my control, means when he will be ready to listen to me, then Swavachne Sthapya. Then I will make him do what I want him to do. Means I will bring him under the control of my words, or I will make him follow my order. Swavachne Sthapya means. Iti mansi vimrishya. So thinking like this, then she speaks. Bho Parameshwara, O Parameshwara, Krishna, avayoho pratikshanameva ati bhaye vardhamane api tav bhaya shankayeva naste. Says both of us, me and my husband, our fear is continuously increasing. But you don't have any fear. So what is this? So to say this, she speaks four slokas. So see, in these four slokas, basically she is explaining why Krishna is not having fear. Sarupam iti chaturbhi. Yadyasya tav tat prasiddhe rupam akaram narayana raghava hashir shadi kam. So he says that yat yasya tav, he says that your form which is well known. So rupam yat tat. So he is saying this yat tat here in the sense of well known forms. So your well known form, which are those? Narayana, Raghava, Bhagavan Ram. Hashir Shadikam. So these are prasiddha forms, well-known forms. So he is describing them, avyaktam. So that form is called avyakta. So what does avyakta means? Sarvendriya agocharam. Vyakta means that which can be experienced with our senses. One sense, two sense, or all the senses, that is called vyakta, and that which cannot be experienced through our senses is called avyakta. Adhyam, that form is adhya. Adhya means ajanyam, unborn. Because if it is born, then it cannot be adhya. So prahur, so rupam yat tat prahur avyakta madhyam. So prahur means, they say, who say this? So here he says that this is said by the Vedas. That Vedas say that your form is avyaktam and adhyam. Tatha nirgunam nirvikaram brahma yasya tav jyotir prahu. And then they also say that your jyoti is called Brahma. So jyoti, that कृष्णा ज्योति और विष्णु ज्योति और भगवान ज्योति. ज्योति मीन्स द एफलजेंस और लाइट. दैट इज कॉल्ड ब्रह्मन. एंड व्हाट आर द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ दैट ब्रह्मन? सो निर्गुणम, निर्विकार, निर्विशेषम, निर्विकारम. दैट दिस ब्रह्मन इज निर्गुण. इट इज विदाउट एनी क्वालिटीज एंड इट इज निर्विकार. इट डज नॉट अंडरगो एनी transformation, unchanging. So that Brahma is your Jyoti. How do the Shrutis say that? Where is it said in the Vedas? Because you are saying the Vedas say hi prahu rupam yattat prahu avyaktam adhyam nirgunam nirvikaram. Where is it said? So he says that yasya bhasa sarvam idam vibhati iti shruti. तमेव भान्तम अनुभान्ति सर्वं यस्य भासा सर्वं इदं विभाति. सेड इन द उपनिषद दैट एवरीथिंग विच एग्जिस्ट्स हियर और विच हैज लाइट हियर, इट इज बिकॉज ऑफ हिज लाइट. ओनली व्हेन ही मैनिफेस्ट हिज पोटेंसी, तमेव भान्तम अनुभान्ति सर्वं, देन ऑल दिस बिकम्स मैनिफेस्ट. अदरवाइज नथिंग कैन. So this is said in Shruti. Then where else it is said? Satyam Jnanam Anantam Yad Brahma Jyoti Sanatanam. So this comes later on in the 28th chapter when coward people, they wanted to see where will they go after this life. And then Krishna showed them his abode by taking them to that Akrur Hrada, Tetu Brahma Hrada Nita. So he made them take a dip. So then what did they see? They saw the Brahma Jyoti. So there also Brahman is called Jnanam, consciousness, Anantam, unlimited, and Jyoti, Sanatana. So all these adjectives are stated there. Ityadi iti agrimokte. This will be said later on. Tatparam Brahma Sarvam Vibhajate Jagat. ममेव तद्घनम तेजो ज्ञातुम अरसि भारते अर्जुनम प्रति हरिवंशे भगवदुक्ते. सो दिस श्लोक वी स्टडीड दिस इन कृष्ण संदर्भ. इफ यू रिमेंबर दिस फ्रॉम हरिवंश पुराण व्हेन देयर वाज टॉक अबाउट महापुरुष महाकाल पुर व्हेन कृष्ण टुक अर्जुन टू महापुरुष व्हेन ब्राह्मण चिल्ड्रन वर स्टोलन बाय हिम. So then Krishna said this, that tat param paramam brahma sarvam vibhajate jagat mameva tad ghanam tejo gyatum arasi bharata. That Arjuna, you should know that dense light which you saw, that is param brahma. And that spreads all over the universe. Sarvam Jagat Vibhajate. And then in Brahma Samhita, famous sloka, Yasya Prabha Prabhavato Jagadanda Koti Koti Swasesha Vasudhadi Vibhutir Bhinnam Tad Brahma Niskalam Anantam Ashesha Bhutam Govindam Adi Purusham Tamham Bhajami. So here also, this Brahma is called Niskalam, means without any parts, Anantam, unlimited, Ashesha Bhutam, is complete, and it is his effulgence. Yasya Prabha means Prabha Govinda, and all these koti koti jagadandas manifest from that. Then in Bhagavad Gita also Krishna says, Brahmano hi pratishtham amritasya vyasya cha. Iti atra swami charanais tatha vyakhyanat cha. So here in this 1427, Sridhar Swami has also commented that this Brahman is the jyoti of Krishna. Vibhuti prasange विकार है पुरुषो अव्यक्तम रजा सत्वम तमः परम श्रीमद्भागवतम इत्र परम इति शब्दस्य ब्रह्मेति तैर व्याख्यानाच. And then in the 11th canto, Krishna describes his vibhuti to Uddhava. So there also, he describes himself, besides other things, by the word Param. And Sridhar Swami says that this Param here means Brahman. So therefore, Brahman is sometimes called as his part, sometimes it is called as his vibhuti, sometimes it is called as his effulgence, right? Sometimes it is called his manifestation without qualities. So there, these are different ways it is described. Madhyam mahimanam cha param brahmeti shabditam iti matsadevoktescha pratpar brahmacete vibhutiya iti yavnacharya stotracha. So it is also stated by Matsadev to King Satyavrata that when the deluge will come, then I will come with a boat and I will speak to you and you will know my Mahima, which means Brahman here. Yamunacharya also says that this Brahman is his vibhuti. Tad brahma krishnyo rakyat kirnarko upmayujoho iti bhaktir samritatcha. Sri Rupa Goswami also describes Brahman as the effulgence of Bhagavan, just like there is light rays coming out from the sun, that they are one. But one is the source, other is the energy. Tatha yasya tav satta matram suddha sattva samanyam suddha satta sakti vilas bhutam iti yavat. And then you are satta matram means you are suddha sattva, means without any mixture of rajas tamas. Swavigraha dham bhakta parikaradikam. So all your dham, vigraha, bhakta, they're all suddha sattva nature. Nirvishesham visheshat prapancha nirgatam prah. And your nirvishesham means, he is giving a very different meaning here, means you are absolutely different from prapancha, which is called vishesha, means which has variety here. Ateva niriham svataha paripurnatvena vitrishnam. Iha means chesta, he also means desire. You do not have any desire because you are completely full in yourself. Yadva sakam bhaktan api nirihyatai iti niriham. Or niriha can also means one who makes his devotees, even those devotees who have material desires, he makes them niskam by fulfilling their desire and then taking the desire out of their heart. Kimva nishreshena ihyati tam abhilashyati iti niriham. Iha also means desire. So it means one who makes the devotee desire him completely and give up all other desires. Spriha iha trada vancha iti amar. According to Amar Kosh, iha, spriha, vancha, trit, they all mean same, means the desire. Satvam Vishnu adhyatma deepa sarvatattva prakashaka iti avigyaya mapi mam mansi yathaspuresi tatham vachmeti. So that person who has all these qualities, that is Vishnu, you, and that is Adhyatma Deepa, that is illuminator of all the tattvas. So although I am ignorant, but by your grace I have this understanding and therefore I am speaking correspondingly. So this is the end of his commentary. If there is any question on this.
Is about this Shanta Bhakta, the Shanta Bhakta, who has no, they don't experience the emotion of fear. They don't experience because their relation is not.
Yeah, because they know that he the fear personified fears him. is situated in knowledge, he is Parameshwara, there is nothing which can harm him. So therefore they don't have any fear. Any other question?
Babaji, I had a question.
Yes.
In the Bhagavad Sandarbha and Guru Goswami explains Brahma, there he explains that there is a Nirvikalpaka Anubhava of Krishna, so of Krishna without his qualities, and therefore that is Krishna Swarupa that's being experienced but without his gunas. His essence, and that's Brahma.
Hmm.
Here we see that this is Vibhuti, almost like a Shakti, where there is a Pirana and the Arka, the ray and the sun. So it is a little puzzling to me, where it's called Shakti, in some places and other places it's said that it is he himself devoid of any Shaktis, when he's experienced devoid of any Shaktis.
Not devoid. That is, I think, is a misunderstanding. Experience with unmanifest. Devoid is different, unmanifest is different. It is avyakta. It's not manifest. Anything else?